Salut comrades and welcome back to Let's Play Hearts of Iron 3. My name is Vadim and you know actually yesterday there was a situation. I was approached two times from beggars, from guys who begged money from me. And the first time there was a strange looking woman, like she was dressed alright, like kind of okay, but when she came, and I thought she would like ask me some time, so I stopped and she, oh, could you please help me with some change? And she did like the saddest face I almost ever seen, and she was like, oh please, I so need money. And I was so disgusted because of that, because like it was fine for a few seconds because I really thought that she wanted to ask me time or directions, but then I was felt kind of betrayed, like when she started, oh I need some money, please help me. And actually my rule is not to give money to the beggars, because I guess it's only makes them to beg some more, like it stimulates them for this type of behavior. Actually in one of the South Park episodes it was clearly shown how like giving change to the beggars only increases their numbers. So I was like, no, fuck it. And but the second time there was a guy who like came all smiley and like, oh come on man, I just need a couple of more rubles to buy some beer. And actually this time it was more okay. Yeah, it was like my mood goes up, you know. I almost gave him. So it made me to a point that from this perspective, I don't know why beggars all try to make you feel worse, yeah, to get money. Why don't them just make you feel better to get some money from you? Like it would be a fair deal. I don't want to give money to somebody who made me feel bad. Like why would you ever? And like musician is a better one because they like playing, and if they play good, you really can get the money, but not to some guys who just want you feel sad and unhappy and fuck it. Okay, yeah, let's go back to the game. I'm moving forward to Italy. It's pretty easily, almost without resistance. I remember, I guess Anthony Draft commented that if Italy joined war with Germany previously, it would give me much more trouble. But actually, no. You see, AI leaves troops on its every border with enemies to fight probable aggression. And even it's exactly on the borders with enemies. I didn't see ever that the United States would reinforce its borders with Mexico and Canada, but the French Italian border is always reinforced, and if Italy would start a fight, there would be enough French troops to draw them back, and it probably would make even better, because we would capture the north of Italy, and then we would have a plazdarm to move to the German territory. Yeah, and actually we now see that Italy isn't that tough of opponent. The Germans is a main threat in the Europe, and yeah, so we are close to Rome now, and we will soon be able to capture Italy. Yeah, in my last video I said that lots of countries joined Axis, and for instance, it was Brazil and Argentina, and soon before the, soon after that they started to attack light on the South Africa, and they are bigger than my allies, so they captured them. So it's another front for me. I started to send in to send their divisions, and I sent one of my fleet to sink Brazilian and Argentinian boats, or I don't know, canoes. I don't know what fleet do they have, but I guess my air carriers will handle it. Then, yeah, I need to. Actually, this is more tough than it might seem from my words. I need a full-scale army there. So from now on, I will send all of my new divisions to South Africa to fight. And I don't know how the situation will turn on. Maybe I will not manage to capture all of its territory before the game ends, because the war in South America, I've always confused South America and South Africa, it's a football syndrome. So, yeah, so in South America, there is always inconvenient fights. Like in Africa, there is the deserts, so it don't stop you from... There is a problem with supplies, but it don't stop you from your mechanized and tank divisions from moving. But in South America, there is lots of jungles, and it makes it worse. Yeah, so... And mountains. So every war there is inconvenient and slow, and back and forth war. I have problems with manpower still. I have just little by little income of manpower, and I build just what I can, like tank division, because it don't require much, and so on. So I will need to... It's only small armies that I am able to produce because of that. And yeah, a little note, when England, after Germans defeated, England declared war on Hungary, and Italy, it declared war to all of Axis, so yeah, and just one more time I want to say, so I am planning, and so it's full cave war, and the Japanese are involved, so I invading from Japan, still on the sea, so it's lots of my air carriers and battleships are patrolling Germans, not German, but Japanese shores, and German shores too, okay. And before that, I don't know, I didn't mention that ever, but I sent them a couple of my fleets to patrol Germans and Italian shore. So now it's time for Japanese. Yeah, I have already sunk a shitload of their fleet, like lots of transport unprotected, some air carriers, some battle cruisers, and so on and so forth. Another war is with China, war with China is, it's more for Great Britain and France, because they have troops there, so they're fighting too. Then with South Africa, yeah, as I said. Okay. And after the Rome is taken, yeah, with my troops. Actually, because the territory that goes once again to Switzerland, it's Switzerland became just superpower from now on. So because of that, Switzerland and Italy, after the Rome taken, Italy don't want to surrender. Then Switzerland just occupies the Italy, and from now on the constant. Switzerland owns the Italy, yeah. And because of Switzerland is a big part of the Allied faction from now on, lots of countries give Switzerland their divisions, yeah, as expedition army. So Switzerland is now the first, the first nation number of brigades. Yeah, so its army is pretty big. Yeah, can you imagine that? So I'm planning to capture Balkans from now on. And then you will see in the next video. But for now, guys, that's it. Thank you for watching, and comrades, dismissed.